Hi, Jeff here. Let me introduce you to some of the newest members of our farm. These are dwarf Nigerian goats, specifically bred for milk, very high quality milk. And this is Bonnie. And at the back there, that's Audrey. Audrey's just about to give birth within the next few weeks. And Bonnie here is pregnant, but only just. Now, this beautiful little girl we nearly lost because she got a paralysis tick very early in the season, a month earlier than they normally start. These are very dangerous ticks. We got her in the nick of time and got anti-serum from the vets, and we had to shave her neck and inject 10 mil into the jugular, and she recovered, luckily. But we've got an old Catamon's trick that we use on all our animals, because this paralysis tick, it can kill young cattle, goats, sheep, geese, ducks, chickens. And it's dangerous to people too. If you leave one on for a few hours, you can be quite sick. So it's definitely something we've got to make sure that we can help the animals defend themselves with. Now, we have a wonderful system using oil of turpentine. It's not mineral turpentine. It's the natural tree oil of turpentine. You can get it from old pharmacies, or you can get it from old hardwares. It's actually an interesting natural remedy. Now, you inject it under the skin, not in the flesh. If you happen to get it in the flesh, they might get a bit of an abscess or a bit of an infection there, but they'll recover. But just under the skin, it gives off a smell from the animal that makes it very defensive for the ticks, because they can't smell the animal. It disguises the smell. And we've saved many young animals from ticks by just using this method. It's a wonderful old system. Many old cattle farmers still use it. The animal is still classified organic because it's an organic oil. Let me show you how it works. And there's a team of us here. Darren, Caleb, Latifa is on the still camera. And we're going to record a medical event here. This is a natural way of preventing ticks. So here we have pure gum turpentine, which is pine oil. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to suck up here 1 mil. It's sticky stuff. You can see I'm not a master at the syringe. There we go. We're going to give them 1 mil. Now, we give our cattle about 3 to 4 mil at about 2 days old, and they don't need it ever again because they get to be a size they can't be killed by this tick. They're too large. Now, what we've got to do is we've got to get the injection under the skin, but not in the flesh. So it gives off a smell through the animal that confuses the tick and gives off a smell. It just doesn't get any attraction to the tick. It can't smell the animal itself. Now, we're going to do the males first, which are always smelly animals themselves because they pee on themselves because they think that smells nice. So we're all going to end up smelly now. So we're going to do the males first, and then we're going to do our females. So here we go. I'm going to try and pull up a section of the neck skin and stick an injection under the skin, but not in the flesh, and squirt it in. And that's all there is to it. Now, people have been very interested in this. So, guys, we're going to try and pull him into the view of the camera. Right.
Whoa, he's lifting me up.
You're going to have to get your hand out of the way.
Yeah.
This is Bruce. I've got it just under the skin. Don't turn your head. And it's thick stuff that takes a bit of push on the syringe to get it in. Done. There you go, Bruce. All for the greater good. So that's sticky stuff. It doesn't want to go in. So I've got to push to get it going gently. I just got to keep pushing and pushing and pushing. And that's just 1 mil going in. Now, if you do go too deep and you get it in the flesh, it doesn't kill them, but they get an abscess and it gets like a lump of flesh there. It swells up. Typically goats, they got really good traction.
They got great traction, a lot of muscle.
Are you shot?
Yeah, I think we're in shot. Ow. All for the good, mate. Yeah, I know it probably stings.
Those ticks will kill you. Good boy. Good boy.
He's going for it. He's going for it.
There we go. There you go.
Who's the boss?
Winston's the boss. Okay. Two done. Now we're going to go over and do the girls. Okay, here we are. And we're on the next one. This is our females. So, this is Audrey.
Sorry, Audrey.
Audrey's about 6 weeks away from giving birth, so we definitely don't want her to get a tick now.
Give her a rub now.
There you go. There you go. Good girl.
Good girl.
Okay. Now we have one to go. And this one we nearly lost to a tick the other day. We're really shocked. Ticks normally don't come on strong till August, and it's the beginning of July. And we nearly lost our young female that's also pregnant, but she's only just pregnant, and she's less than a year old. She's about 10 months old, Bonnie. So that's our last one. So these are all absolutely prize animals for us because they're our new breed stock. Latifah, you're doing well. Right, so come on, pretty little girl. She had a big injection in the neck with the serum, so she's got the anti-serum. Oh, she was given a 10 mil of anti-serum because she had a serious tick and she'd actually already collapsed. But she's all right now, so this is going to prevent any more ticks because she's going to be very vulnerable. So there you go, gum turpentine prevention of ticks. Good to be able to bring it to you.